Next week, this month's developer challenge on the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model, that's CAP, you and me, run by my friend and fellow developer advocate, Nico, is coming to a close. But it's not too late to take part and catch up. Check out Nico's original blog post and also the discussion threads on SAP Community for each of the challenge's tasks. Talking of next week, we're moving from July into August, and that means another developer challenge, this time on the topic of APIs. Look out for an announcement blog post next week on Tuesday, which will explain that developer challenge and what you need to do.
Hey everyone, we have an important update about the service plan migration in SAP BTP ABAP environment, aka Steampunk. As you know, Steampunk supports two types of Cloud Foundry service plans for ABAP systems. One, standard for normal development, test, and productive systems. Two, SaaS OEM for systems to provide multi-tenancy SaaS applications. We had offered 16 ABAP 64 DB service plan in the early days of Steampunk, but in new ABAP systems, this service plan will not be supported. Frank Jens describes in his blog post the importance to switch from the old service plan to standard plan to make sure some of the plan features like the number of ABAP and HANA compute units and two others mentioned here works as expected in your ABAP systems. He has provided the step-by-step procedure to carry out the migration, including the prerequisites. The major advantages of this migration is that it does not change any existing functionality or the size of the system, or doesn't even require any system downtime. So to summarize, this migration to standard plan is a mandatory step to unlock new features and has to be performed by the customers on their development and non-development systems. Please check out this blog post and make sure you have this item on your radar.
Hello, SAP developers. You might now be aware that workflow management and IRPA has been deprecated as of June 2023. And the way moving forward is to go with SAP Build Process Automation. As pointed out in this blog post from Jana Diegler, choosing which option to migrate to can be tricky. At a high level, here are the two choices you are faced with, depending on your use case. Recreate the workflow in a business process or deploy the workflow to SAP Build Process Automation. With the first option, you may want to consider if you can recreate the flow without features such as custom UEFI tasks, iterative logic flow, intermediate message events, etc. Then you might be able to create a future-proof solution. And with the second option, the existing workflow can be adapted with changes to make it work in the SAP Build Process Automation environment. This is a less time-consuming one, since you don't have to rethink your entire process again. You might also have to be conscious of the versioning problem between workflow and automations, and have to maintain them separately. I hope you'll be able to make a better decision on which approach to take by following the information in this blog post as well as official help documentation links provided with you.
If you ask me, one of the key regular activities for any developer is learning. I personally take time to learn on a regular basis to both widen and deepen my knowledge. Talking of learning, there's a new SAP learning journey that we wanted to let you know about on the SAP Integration Suite called Developing with SAP Integration Suite. It's about 9 hours of content and it covers a general introduction to the SAP Integration Suite, managing APIs, managing cloud integration, and also modeling processes. It will also help you prepare for the certification on SAP Integration Suite. What's not to like? Check out Kirsten's blog post for all the details.